This is the YGTV News with Georgina White.
Welcome to the YGTV News. These are the main headlines today on Wednesday, the 15th of February. I'm Georgina White. GDP Federation holds their first conference. Parliament meets for second question time. Wasted appointments in the health service. OEM claims £7 million from government. Government responds to opposition statement on bus route 4A. And finally, Calentita night planned for June. This morning saw the Gibraltar Defence Police Federation's first conference. The meeting boasted addresses from Minister for Justice Mr. Gilbert Ligudi and Baroness Harris of Richmond. YGTV spoke to the chairman of the association, Keith Howard, and Baroness Harris about the conference.
Thank you very much for speaking to us today, Mr. Howard. This is the first of the GDP Federation conferences that you've organised. What is the aim of these conferences?
Well, basically the Gibraltar Security Police moved to Gibraltar Services Police and now the Gibraltar Defence Police. We have had representative committees since 1952 when it was first established. So on our 60th birthday, so to speak, we've actually introduced the last piece of the puzzle in to bring us in line with the manner in which other UK federations and other federations across the Europe actually do. And that is a conference whereby you have speakers addressing the guests and the members. Some of those guests are fraternal guests from overseas, UK, and we've had fraternal guests from the Republic of Ireland also, and obviously local. And we discuss the concerns that we have on the day, but we also give we also run through the problems that we've had the last couple of years, just to remind and take stock of where we were a couple of years ago and where we are now.
Thank you very much for speaking to us, milady. You are very active in the House of Lords within policing, and you're a very good friend of the Gibraltar Defence Police Federation. How do you feel that the Federation has grown?
Well, it's just grown exponentially. The professionalism of the Federation, from the time when I first came about 5 years ago to meet it, has just grown and grown. I'm amazed at how much they've achieved, how they look after and seek the best for their members. And not just for their members, but for the people of Gibraltar.
And a more less serious question, how do you feel about Gibraltar in general?
I love Gibraltar. I love coming here. Everywhere I go, people are so friendly, they're so kind to me. It's just a super place, an absolutely super place to be. I love coming.
Thank you very much for speaking to us.
It's a great pleasure.
Today, members of Parliament sat for the second time since the new government was appointed. This morning's session saw a heated debate between Minister for Employment Mr. Bossano and his opposition counterpart Mr. Daniel Feetham over the Industrial Tribunal Award. This afternoon saw questions from Mr. Feetham on the future job strategy. Mr. Feetham probed Mr. Bossano on how many employees had signed a contract, confirming that they would take on their future job strategy trainees after their 11-month training course. Mr. Bossano replied by telling the opposition that 70 employers had shown their willingness to sign the contract, but will not have to do so for another 30 days. In relation to the graduate trainee scheme, trainees will be earning £1,300.90 a month. So far, only 10 trainees had signed onto the scheme. The year 2011 saw approximately 3,593 missed appointments at the Gibraltar Health Centre. This equates to a whole day of appointments per GP every day. The issue never appears to be addressed, but this could be costing the taxpayers money for lost working hours. Perhaps the GHA would implement a system whereby missed appointments could result in a small fine unless notice is given beforehand. Liquidators of the OEM group will be receiving almost £7 million as full and final settlement of all claims. The claim against the government was made by several companies in the OEM group. It is in respect of the work done on the sites before the previous government took them over. The new government was told that decision to pay was made over a period of time prior to the election. This is the latest development in the OEM saga, which started way back with a decision taken by the GST government to award the company the tender for the construction of the so-called affordable homes in the South District in the first place. The government released a statement yesterday replying to the opposition's report on the number 4A bus route. The statement noted that Minister Neil Costa has replied to all questions regarding the route in last month's Parliament session. The government has said that they will not make any excuses when implementing decisions that improve the quality of life of the elderly. The government, on having received representations whilst in opposition from residents that their journey to their homes was a trek, especially in heat or in cold, and when carrying heavy shopping bags, decided to create the route in order to eliminate the trek for pensioners. This decision is ridiculed by the GST as window dressing. Further, the government merely made use of an existing bus that was available to the Gibraltar Bus Company. And finally, this year's Calentita Festival has been awarded to Word of Mouth. The ministry is working closely with Word of Mouth in order to provide a very enjoyable evening that will once again include a fireworks display. The annual Calentita Night will be held on Friday the 15th of June 2012 at Grand Casemate Square. That's the YGTV News. I'm back tomorrow evening. See you then.